Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to heal the contrite of heart. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you pray for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming out of the clouds of heaven. And when he reached the ancient one and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Pilate said to Jesus, "Are you the King of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you say this on your own, or have others told you about me?" Pilate answered, "I'm not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom did belong to this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not here." So Pilate said to him, "Then you are a king." Jesus answered, "You say I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening, church.
Good evening.
Today we are celebrating the greatest feast that I love the most is Christ the King of the Universe. Mm-hmm. The reason I mention this is because it taught me a lot in my priesthood how to serve the people that the Lord entrusted to my ministry. Let's begin with this feast of Christ the King from the beginning of his birth. Jesus wasn't born in the palaces, am I right?
Right.
He's so humble, born in manger. Mm. And his first visitor was those that tend to the sheep and the magi that traveled that so far to come to see what? The newborn of the king. Mm-hmm. He was born in a manger. Taught me and you to be humble enough in our service. Amen?
Amen.
And then in his public ministry, when the kings of the world speak about power, about the service in the palaces, he walked on the road to meet Bartimaeus and Zacchaeus to heal them. And when the leaders of the whole nations and the countries spoke about concerning those that poor and nobody paid attention to, he was there in the desert to feed those hungry. Amen?
Amen.
And when people talk about how many people dying in the world, and he was there healing the 10 lepers, but how many came back to thank him? Just one. His service and to you and I, not demanding us to come back and give him thanks, but knowing that he has done great things in our lives, then we have the responsibility of coming back to thank him. Mm-hmm. And when he was on that cross, people acknowledged him as King of the Jews. You see the letter on the top. Mm-hmm. And when he was also on the same cross, did they crown him with golden royal crowns? Mm-hmm. No. It was made out of thorn. So what makes you and I so special if we would like to be crowned while our king was crowned with a thorn? And when he was on that cross, the same cross, for all the good things that he has done, they put him on the cross and he was counted among the thieves. But what great thing about it is this, when one of the thieves asked him, "Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom," what did he tell him? today, you will be with me in paradise. It's not about tomorrow, it's not about next year, but it is about today. And on that same cross, I was wondering, where were people that he fed, healed, cured, where are they at? And 5,000 people that he fed, where were they? And 10 lepers that he healed, I was wondering where they at? Church, that's taught you and I that whatever good things that we have done, when we need the most of people to be there to support you and I, you can count on them, but where were they? They were nowhere. But don't worry. When he called Eloi, Eloi lama sabachthani, the Lord is there. Amen, church?
Amen.
And on that same cross, I love the most, but on that same cross, there's a hope that the resurrection. Church, life is rough and tough when you become somebody, yeah? Amen? When you're in charge of something. On that same cross, also they mock him. So what make you and I so special that you want everybody to like you? Amen? Even him that who is so holy, Son of God, people still talk bad about him anyway. Amen? So let's make you and I so humble in our service that he entrusted to us. Today, as we celebrate the Christ, the King of Universe, this feast taught you and I great, great lessons to be humble enough in our service. Even sometimes nobody wanna talk to you or nobody wanna respect what you're doing. But keep in your mind, you're doing it for the Lord.
Amen.
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 And also taught us to how to render the love. Because of his love to the world, God sent his only Son and died for you and I. He was willing to die on the cross because of his love for you and I. So why don't we share the same love? And why don't we not talk to our neighbors? And why do we don't want to talk to somebody that sometimes step on our toe? If he is the good one, show us that love and willing to sacrifice his life for you and I as his followers. Why don't we do the same thing? Church, think about it. In closing, I've been practicing this song for the longest, Barbara and Margarita. I would like to sing this song. This song was written by Mary Jane Wilkin when she was in her 53. She went through a lot in her life. By then, when she wrote this song, she was well known with a lot of gospel songs. But this song was hit because she lost her husband as a pilot in World War II in South Africa. And she was wondering whether the Lord still remembered her where she at. And she was like on the wrong side of the road. And even she started to go to the church. So one day, she was wondering if she would need somebody to talk to. So she went to the church, talked to a minister. She drove a nice Cadillac, so fancy, with the big head and with the cowboy boot, and show up at the church to talk to the minister. When the minister saw her, he asked, "What's your problem? It seems like you have problem. You have no financial problem because you drive a nice car." And she said, "No, I don't have a problem with that." And when he looked at her, she was so healthy. And he said, "Well, I don't think you have a problem with your health." And she said, "No." And at the end of the conversation, the minister asked her this question that stick with her. Because she told the minister about what she was going through a lot, and she quit the church. And the minister asked her, "Did you ever think about thank God for all the problems that you have. And at that point, she realized and drove back to her house. The house was empty. And she sat down on her piano. And she played this song. She started with the first line. One day at a time. Just give me the strength to do every day. But then she didn't finish the song because she was confused how to start the first line. So she called on Chris Christopherson. And back then, Chris was start to release her first album about Why Me, Lord. So they sat down at a nice table for coffee. And Chris told her, why don't you start with I'm just only human. And I'm just a man. So this is how the song goes. So I know you know the song. You can sing along with me. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be. Ask Jesus to give you the strength and show you the way. Mm. You can make it, church.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Please stand.
one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father.
Through him all things were made.
For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven,
and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Our God is the one who is, who was, and who is to come, and so we always can turn to heaven for God's generous assistance.
For the church, that we may listen to the voice of our Savior as he testifies to the truth, and that inspired by the Holy Spirit, we may discern the truth and apply it to our lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All around the world, rulers may strive for justice and peace as they lead their nations with humility and benevolence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who live under repressive regimes and all who are oppressed by unjust authorities, they may be sustained daily in hope during their time of trial. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have harmed others, that they may feel truly remorseful for their actions and be moved to repent for their sins and be given the chance to show their remorse. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those seeking the source of all goodness may find the face of Jesus Christ, the King, reflected in the witness of our faith community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For hearts to be opened to the call to foster and adopt, for Emiliana and all children in foster care, that they be matched with a loving adoptive family, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for the intention of this Mass, which is for Kristen Roberts celebrating her birthday, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for the prayer request that we've received this week on Flock Note for the sick, Alicia Black, Andrew Freeman, Annette Kengel, Bernadette Guillory, Carl Warren, Conrad Johnson, Dorothy Sneed, Eulalie Brown, Evelio Penalver, Henry Thomas, Ingrid Brady O'Neill, Casey Bowick, Lois Cupid, Marguerite Ruiz, Roland Carrington, and Terrence Simmons. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for the recently departed and the souls of all the faithful departed, that through the mercy of God they may rest in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the souls, all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions spoken and unspoken. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Eternal God, you created us in your image, sent your Son to redeem us, and continue to watch over us always. Graciously hear the prayers we make today and every day through your Son, our Lord and King of the universe. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
acceptable to God, to your mighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and the glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
As we offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness, as eternal priest and king of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption and making all created things subject to his rule. He might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her most spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have visited throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Amen.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come and be spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were all
Father Christ,
and unite myself
Father Christ,
to you. Never
Father
forget
Christ,
me to be separated from you.
Father Christ. Father Christ.
Thank you.
want to thank also our ushers and the people that Dale, who connects us with our mission ones at home every Sunday at great personal expense and difficulty. But she does it because she loves the Lord and loves this church. We want to thank Barbara Twine Thomas, who is going to receive the St. Jude Medal Award from the bishop tomorrow.
Amen.
Mass is 3 o'clock in the afternoon in the cathedral, so if you happen to be in the neighborhood, please drop by, and if not, drop by anyway, because Barbara has done so much good work for us, including being our sacristan for this Saturday Mass, and she rarely misses. It's got to be a major event for her to put anything else above her duty to our church and to her duties here. I want to thank Father for celebrating today, wonderful homily today, mm-hmm. Father. Needs a musician on his own, don't you think? he could have been in New York on one of the big stages, and here he is performing for us. Thank you for that sacrifice. And Debbie, thank you for being on our honorable servant today. And earlier today at the funeral, Debbie was there with her husband, Wayne. And he's old, and he got tired, so home, and so Debbie came back to do it again. Thank you so much. So, before we go, are there any first-time visitors in our parish? Anyone who's never ventured through those doors before that is willing to admit it? No? Okay. I remember when Pam and I were first-time visitors, and we were asked that question, and we kind of quietly raised our hand and got this uproarious pause, and you know, and it just felt so welcome. It was just a great place to be. How about birthdays or anniversaries or new births? For anyone in your family or yourselves or indirect family, old family, none? All right, well, that kind of week, I guess. So come back tomorrow, please, for Sylvia's coffee. She's going to be gone, but she's trained someone to do that for her. So if you're coming to Mass again tomorrow, you have the chance to see how the new person will do it. God bless you all, and have a wonderful day.
Okay. All right. Since we don't have birthdays and wedding anniversary, so would you mind stand and join us for the closing prayer? Let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, that glorifying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.